welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Ben Turney, the CEO of Kavango Resources. A very warm welcome to you, Ben, and plenty of news out recently from Kavango. But this morning, you published something which was an unexpectedly nice surprise for you, wasn't it?
Yeah, it really has been. I actually found out the news when I was coming back from Africa last week. I was on the plane after an exhausted trip, and at about 6 a.m, I was standing in the galley, beavering away, and the email came through from Jeremy in Canada that we'd had this updated report from Dr. Moomin. And it was, I hope it's going to prove to be one of those seminal moments in my career. So it was very, very unexpected, very welcome, and hopefully the 2022 year of discovery is back in play.
Fantastic. So perhaps you'd just like to give us a quick summary of that news.
So we've encountered a wide, or thick, I should say, banded iron formation in our DIT DD004 hole that we drilled last year at our Ditau project. Now, we were looking for carbonatites. That was our original exploration model. It was a geophysics-led exploration program. So the Ditau area is covered by, in the region of 50 to 70 meters of Kalahari sand. So there's no geology at surface. That's one of the key challenges working in Botswana, but it's obviously one of our key specialisms as well. We are a technology-focused and technology-driven company. We deploy the latest remote sensing technologies across our projects. Now, our guys, Hillary in particular, had interpreted that there were 12 ring structures that conformed to potential the same geophysical signatures as a carbonatites. So our proof of concept drill campaign last year was aimed at trying to prove this carbonatite model. Now, of course, we didn't end up hitting any carbonatites, but what we did hit was this rock formation that we didn't know exactly what it was. These beautiful red rocks that we've published on social media and put in, out in today's RNS. Now, we did some petrological work last year, and we had one expert reviewed that and came back to us and said that, look, there's IOCG potential in these rocks. That's iron oxide, copper, gold. We could see readings, anomalous readings for all three of those elements. And so we thought we might be looking at an IOCG system. So we sent the data over to Dr. Moomin. Jeremy reached out to Dr. Moomin last year, and he persuaded him to come and do some consulting work for us. So we sent it over with the brief of Dr. Moomin to look at this from the IOCG perspective, because he is one of the world's leading authorities in these. He's a professor of economic geology. You know, what part of our mission now with Kavango is to bring in the best expert advice we can to help guide our exploration program. So this move was very much in keeping with that. What we didn't expect was Dr. Moomin to come back to us with his preliminary results, and they are preliminary at this stage. There's more work we need to do, but his view is that what we've actually stumbled into is potentially a lode gold system connected to this very thick banded iron formation that we've encountered. Now, if you look at similar formations worldwide, these type of lode gold systems hosted within banded iron formations, they can run to multi-million ounces, and in some cases world-class potential for gold discovery. So it really is a very exciting step forward for Kavango. It wasn't what we were looking for, but I think that's also part of the exploration game sometimes. We've drilled as many holes as we could into the targets we've gone for. We didn't know what would be there. We were looking to try and prove a mineral deposit model, but obviously we've ended up now with something completely different. So it means back to the drawing board. We're now looking at all of the data we have, and we're now planning out the next stages of exploration.
Very interesting, Ben. So it sounds like you believe the thickness of that banded iron formation is potentially significant.
We believe it is. So the key thing about the thickness of the formation is that, first of all, you're looking at what's called a very brecciated zone. So the zone of interest is about 100 meters. We could see that very clearly from the beginning. And what that basically means is that the rocks are very broken up. Now, those broken up rocks, they would have allowed millions of years ago, they would have allowed hydrothermal fluids superheated to have flowed through this system, obviously containing metallic elements within them. Now, what you then need for a system of this style is some form of catalyst, some form of geochemical change to enable the minerals to drop out of the fluids. That's what the iron provides. So the banded iron formation is obviously, it's 100 meters thick. It's got some intervening mudstones, but by and large, it appears to be contiguous. And the iron provides basically a chemical trap to enable gold to drop out of the hydrothermal fluids. the thickness of the BIF that we've encountered is significant because, first of all, it's open at depth. So we didn't actually get to the bottom of it. So that means there's more underneath us. But obviously, the thicker the system, the more potential there is for more volume of hydrothermal fluids to have passed through. So given that we've got shows of gold there in our existing assay results, and we're going to be doing more comprehensive assays on the entire section as part of Dr. Moomin's advice, but we've got a system that we believe could be pregnant for gold mineralization. It's now a case of trying to find potential traps, potential zones where this gold might have accumulated, hopefully into what might even be an economic mine one day. So it's a very, very exciting exploration lead for us.
So just finally, Ben, just to help me get a better sense of the potential significance of this news, is this something that you think could be transformational for Kavango, or is it just more of a little bonus for you, do you think?
It could be transformational for us. I mean, it wasn't what we were originally looking for by any means, but these are by a long way the best results we as a company have ever had. We've obviously got to do more work over the next couple of months to both verify Dr. Moomin's initial findings. We've got to go back to the drawing board with our geophysics. We're also chasing up some leads with some holes that were drilled on the particular target that we targeted last year by another company who had the overlapping diamonds license. So there was additional exploration that was conducted just before us. So the more we can learn about the system, the better. One of the good aspects about this particular deposit style is that these BIFs are heavily magnetic. So we published a picture in the RNS today showing the magnetic pencil. We got a strong response throughout the entire 100 meters. And that's good news for us because some of the technology that we use can map these magnetic bodies from surface. We've already demonstrated in the KSZ that we are excellent as a company at identifying and being able to map these magnetic bodies. So since we are now chasing a magnetic body that could actually host potentially large-scale gold mineralization, that's very good news for us moving forward. But there's obviously a lot of work that we need to do. Ultimately, we're going to have to come back with the drill rig. We know that we've got to deepen hole DD004. We want to try and chase that BIF to the end. We need to see how deep it runs. The only way we can do that is with drilling. So we expect there'll be an initial bit of geological drilling just to help orientate us. But then when we return with the drill rig, probably at some point during the towards the end of the second half this year, we'll be in full discovery mode. So we will be looking for gold mineralization. So it really does have the potential to be transformational for our business.
Fantastic. Well, what an intriguing mystery. And I hope we'll get an update on it before long, Ben. But until then, thanks very much for coming to talk to us at Proactive today.
Thanks for having me.